Hey, Cameron McKenzie here, editor-in-chief at theserverside.com. Follow me on Twitter at CameronMCNZ, and I wanted to talk to you about your Git config settings once again. And in this case, I want to tell you how to delete things that are inside that Git config. And there's actually three ways to do it, and I'm going to show you all three. Let's open up a terminal window and take a look at what these Git settings are. I have a project called squash commits example. I'm going to move in there. And from here, I'm going to issue that git config list. But list isn't good enough because it doesn't really tell me where these files are being set. If I actually include the show origin, you can actually see which files are setting these different properties. And you can see there's the system setting right there. I'm not going to worry about the system setting because anything that's in the global setting or the local setting will override the system setting. So as long as I've got something in these other scopes, I'm fine. Now it does look like the email was written incorrectly for the global git config. And so why don't I just remove that? And that's just a matter of git config dash dash unset. It is in the global scope and the property is user.email. And if I now do the git list show origin, magically that user.email is gone. Now there's another way that you can actually do this. You can, rather than unsetting an individual command, you can always go in and just ask to edit that global config file. And the switches you can use are global, local, system. There's also a portable scope and a worktree scope. But if you just go in and say edit, it'll open up this page and maybe that name global you want to delete. That is now deleted. We're in nano, so to get out of here, it's got to be a control O and an enter, and that writes it out, and then a control X to exit. But if I take a look at these different properties, you'll notice that that value is gone as well. And I've got an interesting situation down here in my local git config, and I've got two fields with the same property. And that can happen if you go git config dash, I think it's the dash add command, and then you say user.name, and then say Joey Joe. Notice we now have another name. Now the problem with this is if you try and do your little unset trick, and you've got multiple fields there, here we'll do the unset command, but locally. And so git config unset local and user.email, and it's not email, it's name. Let's get precise. You notice that I actually get this warning, user.name has multiple values. And if I actually do the git list show origin, you'll notice that nothing's been done. So in this case, you have to take extreme measures. And the command that you do here is git config, but you throw in the dash dash replace all. And it's the unset all command I want. Let me get this done correctly. So git config, then it would be unset dash all dash dash local user.name. Click enter. Let's take a look at that entire list. And you notice that now those files are gone. So there you go. Those are three different ways to delete values in your git config file. So one is unset, another is unset all, and then, you know, I guess you can always drop a hammer and just go in and edit it in a nano or text editor. And there you go. That's how you can easily delete some settings in your git config files. Now, if you want to learn more, head over to theserverside.com. Lots of git tutorials over there and anything to do with enterprise software development and DevOps. I'm the editor in chief, so hopefully we keep some good content up there. If you want to follow my personal antics, I'm at CameronMCNZ on Twitter, and subscribe on YouTube.